Midterm exam. So, in your packets, we've given you a practice midterm exam. And the first page is the rubric. And so, if you take a look at each section, there's basically three units we've covered so far: nature, science, scientific method, the structure of the atom, and periodic table and ions. And so, this is what us teachers will use when we grade your final. You'll have more sections because we have quarter two material, but you can actually grade yourself as you go and see how you would have done if this truly were a final. Keep in mind though, it's all in class work. So let's go on to the first section. So this first section, please notice it's a memory portion of the quiz. So in this section, during your final, you won't get to use a periodic table or any other reference sheets. It's all from memory. So let's go over the beginning of it. First part is related to safety, after your safety quiz. And so it may be some of these questions, but most likely some other examples. So here's a key for that: false, 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 true, false. And then the next one would be element identification, like the elements quiz. Iron is Fe. Oxygen is O, lithium is Li, aluminum, Al, bromine for Br. Keep in mind that you may want to retake the elements quiz now after working with the periodic table so much now. Most likely, you'll do better. And keep that in mind, you can retake any skill check over first quarter, even though we're into second quarter. All right, the next section is scientific method and variables. So you do need to memorize the steps to the scientific method. The first part, get my arrow up here, is question. And that's all you have to write, but we need you to have it be two parts. Make sure to identify the independent and dependent. We'll get into that more later. Make sure also not to make it an if-then statement. That'll be for the hypothesis. Next is research. And that's where we're going to research any information on that experiment that may have done before, or even using your past life experiences. Then there's hypothesis. This does need to be an if-then statement, and the independent and dependent variable need to show up again. Then you're going to perform the experiment, where you actually test how does changing your independent variable affect your dependent variable. Then analysis. And that's where you're going to do some graphs, some averaging, ranking, sorting, all that sort of stuff on your raw data. And then finally, a conclusion. And that's where you'll provide a summary of the experiment and was your hypothesis supported or not. The big thing on a conclusion is we don't prove anything. The data will support or not support your hypothesis. And you can provide an overview of the analysis of data as well. Any patterns you see or sources of error, or what you could do to improve the experiment. Okay, the next section is identifying the independent dependent variables, and then as well as control, and be able to write a question and a hypothesis based off of that. So on your final, we'll give you something similar to this. We'll give you two statements: the amount of baking soda I add and the amount of CO2 gas produced. Your challenge will be to identify what would you change of these two and what would be measured. Independent variable, remember, is what is changed. And so the amount of baking soda I add is the changed independent variable. And you can measure the amount of CO2 gas produced. Then, based off of that, we want you to come up with some control experiments or control variables. So you need to brainstorm what else could change that might affect the amount of CO2 gas produced. Temperature might be it, pressure, the size or shape of the container are all good examples. The worst thing you could do though is have baking soda show up as a control. That's bad, because you need to change that, not keep it constant. So make sure to be careful of that. That's a common mistake students make. Then we'll get into how to write a question off of that. So here, Whatever is your independent variable, how will changing the amount of baking soda? So again, whatever you put up here will show up in the question. Affect the amount of, again, right here is where your dependent variable goes. Next section is structure the atom. And our hope is that you can actually see how we're going to make your final. If you look at your quizzes, you should see questions very similar to what's shown up on the midterm. And so we don't want any surprises. So one quiz was on electron configuration of atoms. And so if we give you the electron configuration, we want you to tell us the element. Or vice versa, if we give you the element, we would like you to tell us the electron configuration. So in this example, real simple trick is to add up the superscripts 2 + 2 + 3, and that equals 7. 7 electrons, and because electrons have to equal protons, that's the atomic number, nitrogen. And if we give you the element, and we want you to write the electron configuration, probably the easiest thing to do on that one is to know the bingo effect of the periodic table. So column 1 and 2 are the S1, S2 column, and then the rows, row 1, row 2, etc. If this makes no sense to you, please go see your teacher and review this. Isotopes. This section is real similar. Probably the only thing that's unique is a shorthand symbol. We're here where you put the element symbol, the mass goes on top, atomic number goes on bottom. Again, make sure you're getting the mass from the provided information. So protons plus neutrons is how you get 33, and then this 33 goes up on top. And then the other part that's new is when you write isotopes in this form, you write sulfur-33. In other words, the element name dash whatever the mass is. Okay, so here's a quick overview of the answers to your midterm. For practice, you can check those. And we'll move on to ions. Ions. So you will get to use your periodic table and your common ion sheet that has the heavy metals and the polyatomic ions. And so that's your challenge, is to know where to look. So the example provided, lithium is on the periodic table. It's in group 1A, so it's plus. And because it's positive, it's a cation. When you read iode, you're thinking, okay, I probably should look in group 5, 6, 7 on the periodic table. And sulfur you find is in 6A, so it's 2 minus. And it's an anion, it's negative. When you see more than one element, it's a polyatomic ion. So that's ammonia on your sheet. When you see Roman numerals, that makes it a heavy metal. So again, just use your reference sheet. The Roman numeral is the charge. And then again, more than one element makes it a polyatomic ion. So this is carbonate. Isotopes. This section is real similar. Probably the only thing that's unique is a shorthand symbol. We're here where you put the element symbol, the mass goes on top, atomic number goes on bottom. Again, make sure you're getting the mass from the provided information. So protons plus neutrons is how you get 33, and then this 33 goes up on top. And then the other part that's new is when you write isotopes in this form, you write sulfur-33. In other words, the element name dash whatever the mass is. Okay, so here's a quick overview of the answers to your midterm. For practice, you can check those. And then we'll move on to ions. Ions. So you will get to use your periodic table and your common ion sheet that has the heavy metals and the polyatomic ions. And so that's your challenge, is to know where to look. So the example provided, lithium is on the periodic table. It's in group 1A, so it's plus. And because it's positive, it's a cation. When you read iode, you're thinking, okay, I probably should look in group 5, 6, 7 on the periodic table. And sulfur you find is in 6A, so it's 2 minus, and it's an anion, it's negative. When you see more than one element, it's a polyatomic ion. So that's ammonia on your sheet. When you see Roman numerals, that makes it a heavy metal. So again, just use your reference sheet. The Roman numeral is the charge. And then again, more than one element makes it a polyatomic ion. So this is carbonate. So what's being shown here is your scoring guide for your final. So the first part should look familiar. And then what we're showing you here is the other sections that'll be on your final. So the first part, scientific method, steps, how to write a good question, and hypothesis. Don't forget that also includes how to identify control variables. Then we're getting into a memorization section with the element identification. Then you get to use your periodic table common ion sheet for electron configuration, atomic structure, isotopes, ions, ion formation, periodic table, and then properties of the, and trends of the periodic table, like the alien periodic table lab we did this week. And then the new material will be bonding, ionic bonds, covalent bonds, metallic bonds, how to write formulas for ionic and covalent bonds. And then finally, the very last section is on the mole and reaction types and balancing, and finally predicting products. So that's an overview of the whole semester. So it helps to have the big picture in mind when you prepare for this final, but also to know where you're at within each unit. Good luck. Don't forget to keep getting help along the way, and more later.